voisins et surtout de véritables amis, to shared history and shared hope, to shared prosperity, and to the shared peace and security that binds Canada and the United States together as allies, as neighbors, and most importantly, as true friends. Sláinte. Santé.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a privilege to introduce the Honorable Joseph R. Biden Jr., President of the United States of America. Mesdames et messieurs, l'honorable Joseph R. Biden Jr., President des États-Unis d'Amérique.
Thank you very much. If y'all keep this up, I'm not going to want to go home. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Justin and Sophie, thank you for hosting us for this supper here in Ottawa. And in my speech to Parliament earlier today, I quoted a famous Canadian poem in Flanders Field. More than 100 years ago, from the battlefields of France, Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae wrote, and I quote, "To you from the from failing hands, we throw the torch, be yours to hold it high. You know, from the poppy fields that we saw, and it was incredible to be there, by the way, in Flanders Field and when on the anniversary, the 50th anniversary, that to the landing grounds in Normandy, to today when our nations still hold the torch very high for democracy, for equality, for freedom, and for our children. Together, we've always found hope and light, creating a better future for all our people. We've always gotten to that point. That's because we're more than neighbors. And I mean this from the bottom of my heart. We're more than neighbors. We're more than partners. We're more than friends. And you alluded to it today, just a moment ago, Mr. Prime Minister. We're more like family. We're more like family. We stand together as friends and as family. And for that reason, I'm optimistic about our future, because I really am optimistic about our future. And I'm very proud of our past. And rather than take you through much longer toast here, let me conclude by saying, you know, my grandfather Finnegan used to have a toast, he'd joke about an Irish toast, and he'd say, "May those who love us, and those who don't, may God turn their ankle so we know they're limping when they're coming." Well, I kind of wish you that toast too, but at any rate. But speaking of Seamus Heaney, Seamus' poem, The Cure of Troy, was about hope and history rhyming. He said, "History teaches us not to hope on this side of the grave, but then, once in a lifetime, that longed-for tidal wave of justice rises up and hope and history rhyme." I believe with every fiber of my being, we're at an inflection point where we can take control of that quote. I think we can make, if we have the strength and the courage and we stick together as family, we can make hope and history rhyme. So, ladies and gentlemen, to all the family, U.S. and Canadian, and this is a hell of a thing to do, to toast with water. By the way, my grandfather used to say, if you toast with anything other than alcohol, you have to do it with your left hand. His name was Ambrose Finnegan. So, ladies and gentlemen, to family, to Canada, and to the United States, hear, hear. Thank you, man.
I would like to thank the Right Honorable Justin Trudeau and the Honorable Joseph R. Biden Jr. for their remarks. I now invite you all to enjoy your meal and have a good evening. Je remercie le très honorable Justin Trudeau et l'honorable Joseph R. Biden Jr. pour leurs remarques. Je vous invite maintenant à profiter du repas et de votre soirée. Please remain in your seats for the duration of the dinner. Veuillez rester à vos sièges assignés pour la durée du repas. Merci.